Revelio. Do you want to win this Harry Potter themed mystery box? Stick around to the end of the video to know how. Netflix's latest animation is sadly a forgettable film for adults, but it's definitely a good time waster for children on a rainy day. Hi, it's Kieran here at Raw Review, and Netflix has delivered some incredible movies recently, some of the decade so far. Last year, the streaming service released two Academy Award nominated films with The Sea Beast and Oscar winning Pinocchio. This year, we can imagine that the same will be true for the streaming service, thanks to the hilarious, heartwarming, and simply fantastic animated flick Nimona. With all these previous titles getting praise, it's hard to imagine that Netflix and the creative minds behind these movies will drop the ball anytime soon. However, Netflix's The Monkey King fails to live up to the rest. But don't get me wrong, it's still worthy to grab the attention of the younger audiences. The Monkey King is simply a forgettable flick that doesn't offer enough to keep the audiences engaged. There are plenty of other animated flicks to watch this year instead. The characters are pretty irritating, the story doesn't present anything unique or original, and the majority of the humour sadly falls flat. That said, this film does have some saving graces. The animation was pretty good, and the action was surprisingly fluid. But the best part about this film is the voice cast, with the likes of Jimmy O Yang, Jolie Hong Rappaport, Horn Lee, Stephanie Shi, and BD Wong. While The Monkey King isn't all bad, its poor script doesn't present enough for audiences to get excited for this film. From Anthony Stachy, who's directed films such as Open Season and Box Trolls, comes a timeless tale that you've most likely heard before. The Monkey King follows a heroic monkey with a magical fighting stick as he goes on an epic quest for victory. Monkey must defeat over 100 demons and an eccentric water dragon in order to become immortal and therefore granted the power of the gods. Along the way, Monkey must battle the greatest foe of them all, his ego. Monkey also meets a selfless young village girl who challenges his self-centered attitude and shows him that even the smallest pebble can have a big effect on the world. The film was written by Steve Benchich and Ron J. Fieldman, who both worked on animated classics such as Brother Bear, Chicken Little, and Open Season. They are also joined by Rita Hayso, who co-wrote the original Mulan and Toy Story 2. The film is a retelling of a classic Chinese tale with enough new elements and story beats to keep the Netflix movie feeling original. The films like Egotism and The Search for Self-Fulfillment have been done before time and time again. However, wrapped in this classic Chinese tale and modernised, they do work pretty well. Yes, as previously mentioned, The Monkey King is pretty forgettable, but that doesn't mean it's a wholly terrible animated film. The film's aesthetic, fluidity, use of light and shadow, and character design feels like an authentic Chinese animated flick. One of the movie's more enjoyable and surprising aspects is the action sequences. It's fast-paced, well-designed, and the choreography is stunning. Whether the Monkey King is fighting a giant water dragon, a small fire demon, a god, or a multiplying creature from the depths of hell, each fight is seamless, unique, and incredibly fun. Thankfully, there are plenty of fights in the 90-minute running time to keep audiences' attention from veering off. With its 90-minute running time and the movie's relentless pacing, it certainly does fly by. It's actually quite refreshing to have a 90-minute running time instead of a bloated blockbuster we're so used to seeing now. That said, we don't spend a lot of time with the characters, and any character growth or development feels cheap and unwarranted. To some, this may not be a massive criticism, as most of the movie is for young kids. But for those looking for a more complex animated feature, I'd recommend something more in-depth. Let's be honest, animated films typically get a bad rep. Many label any and every animated movie as a kid's movie, regardless of its messaging, themes, and comedy, forcing many adults to steer away from some great animated films. Sadly, The Monkey King doesn't help, and could have done more to offer a more elevated experience, not just for kids. The humour will definitely land for the kids, but will frustrate adults with its stupidity. The characters are unpleasantly infuriating, with the majority just being over-the-top characters. And there is one lackluster and incredibly strange musical number that doesn't really fit in with this film. Perhaps if the movie had more likeable characters, the humour just wasn't cheap slapstick, and somewhat of a slower pace, there could have been a great animated feature here for all ages. At the end of the day, The Monkey King lacks any type of charm and magic. There is simply no heart to this movie, and when you have a main character like Monkey, it's not hard to see why. Monkey is such an unlikable and annoying protagonist. He's selfish, arrogant, and by waving his magic stick around that grants magical abilities, he thinks he's the most powerful being on the planet. Although he does learn the errors of his ways, it's never consequential enough to make his horrendous behaviour forgivable. The only character worth caring remotely about is the young village girl, who essentially sells her soul in order to grant her village the water needed to end their famine forever. In order for her wish to be granted, she must betray the Monkey King and steal his stick. As a parent, that is not a great message to tell the kids. Ultimately, this film does send some mixed messages, making it seem okay to do wrong for the greater good. But that's just my thoughts and feelings about the film. If you've seen it, I'd love to know what you thought about it in the comments below. And if you want to win this magical Harry Potter themed mystery box, all you need to do are these three simple things. Number one, leave a like on this video. Number two, leave a comment on any of my videos. It could be just as simple as a heart emoji. And number three is the most important, make sure you are subscribed. And one lucky random subscriber will be announced on the 30th of September. You can even hit that bell icon to keep up to date with my latest uploads and giveaways, such as my comic book giveaways every fortnight. And guys, just before I go, if you enjoyed this video, then make sure you smash that like and subscribe button. And I appreciate every single one of you that already has, so thank you. So with all of that being said, I will see you in the next one, but until then, take care.